Hello. Hello and welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox on the Series X on this sunny Monday morning here in the United Kingdom for me. This is a tutorial on merge blocks. A short one. I want to speak about one of the issues that's plaguing merge blocks and grids at the moment, but also show a couple of things on why you want to use merge blocks. Merge blocks are extremely useful and they function most of the time when your grid is a ship. When your grid is a station, you can have some odd effects happen. So, looking at this, is my little station grid here. I have two merge blocks connected to a control seat. The piston, and if we just jump into this and I activate the piston, you will see that our merge blocks will come down and they'll automatically lock off. Now they won't move again, even if you press and reverse on the piston button. You have to unlock the merge block. Now the merge block will unlock if your grid has been built as part of asteroid or ground voxels, as you'll see here, allowing the two to separate. If your grid, on the other hand, is free floating at this point in time, and I have submitted this as a bug to Keen Software, and they're looking into it, it's an awaiting a fix. You'll see that if I try and turn off the merge block, press the piston button, it won't work. Now, if I turn this grid by pressing the inventory button, going all the way to info, and pressing X to convert to ship, it'll work. But phantom forces will happen. You will get clang. I will demonstrate this in a moment. Just know that convert to ship and convert to station will only function on a grid that is not intersecting voxels and is stationary. Once this grid starts to move, that's it. It can't be converted back to a station or a ship the moment that it starts to move. So if we press X on it, you'll see that because I'm sitting in the chair, we're all right at this moment. But you can get phantom forces happen. If you notice, we've actually gone down. I go into external view and press the piston button, you'll see that our grid behaves rather weirdly. Very strange indeed. But because it's stationary, I can convert it back to station. The moment it's converted back to a station, it cannot go back to a ship, and you'll get that error message. So, convert it back to a ship. Now you'll see some weird phantom forces happen. So before this grid causes any damage, we'll cut it. That is something that is being looked at though by Keen. So with the merge block, if you want to connect two grids together, but you want them to separate, and you might want to do that because you want to create a ship similar maybe to some Star Wars ships that has its own separate jump drive. Or if you want to weld two grids together, you can do it this way. These two grids like this. So now, when I trigger my merge blocks, they're on. When I bring these two grids down, or this grid down to the other grid, when the merge blocks merge, you'll see that those grids are now connected. If I try and turn off the merge block and activate the piston, it's not going to work. That's because the game has now welded these two separate grids into one. Only way to separate them is by splitting one of the grids away from the other. Now, why do you want merge blocks in the first place? Well, one of the reasons is if you're playing around with airtight systems, you may notice that custom airtight doors are a pain to get to work. This is a station built off the Red Ship map station, little platform, and we have our hinge, a merge block, and if I activate this, you can see my little camera here going inside now. Because it merges, the camera will quit. But if we go back to the camera, you can see inside, if I hold down both bumpers and push backwards and forwards on the stick, I'll zoom the camera. But you'll see that we have an atmosphere. I exit camera view. That is an airtight, locked, custom hangar or chamber using a merge block. And that's when you want merge blocks. That's how merge blocks work. And the reason this works, I'll leave a link to my original video showing how to build it, but there is a hinge here and a hinge attached to it. And if you build it like this, exactly as I've done, and you make sure that none of these sides touch here, so really the block is just touching the gap, you can get the airtight room to split once it's connected. So we'll pop that. As you'll see, we can lower our door again. Once again, open. Now, the reason I built this is to demonstrate what happens again as part of my bug finding for Keen if this system is triggered on a free-built station, a station that's not connected to voxels at any point, or has been connected to the voxels at any point, just one you build out in space. If I activate this, you'll see that it has issues connecting to the merge block to begin with. And because it's a station, not ship, see, where's my hinge? Angle is 4. established. There we go. The angle is now locked in. You can hear it start to pressurize. Well, it's locked. I can't now move that door. The only time that door will move is if, once again, we go here and we convert it to a ship, and then it will trigger some phantom forces. So that's the unexpected behavior you can get from merge blocks, unless they're built directly onto a previous station or built into the voxels like this grid here. So earlier I mentioned the idea of a Star Wars style Jedi jump ship, a ship that has its own external jump drive rather than a jump drive built into the ship. This is one of the functions of a merge block, and as long as there's no other blocks surrounding this merge block that will merge to each other, you can make a little module like this. I've got a jump drive, I've got some reactors, I've got some thrusters, and what will happen if we jump into this little control seat here and we bring our blue ship back, turn our merge block on. Before we join forces, we will just check the jump drive on the ship. That's giving us 1850 kilometer jump. Now, if we pull back until the lights go green, we're now locked in. The ship is now linked as part of that grid, which means these thrusters, which normally wouldn't work because they're on a subgrid, are now considered part of the main grid, and we have full control and more thrust. Got to watch though, because thrusting too fast, too hard can cause issues with merge blocks. Sometimes going backwards and forwards like that. Again, be careful. But what I was talking about was the jump drive. So now, because it has a jump drive attached to another jump drive, we've got a massive 3,103 kilometer jump. All because we've attached this little jump rig via a merge block to the back. And if we split it again, we can go away. So if you don't have a jump shape capable ship, and you don't fancy building a jump drive onto the ship, you just want to make a jump ring consisting of several jump drives, you can do it using a merge block and then just park your ship to the back, go to your jump drive, and you can add any of your jump drives by holding down on the D-pad. And the rule is just add one. You don't need to add them all, don't need to group them. Just pick your one and then choose jump from this list, and then if you do it right, you can see that it will tell you how far the jump will be. Make sure that your crew are seated, and then see the jump is successful. And both drives are now discharged and charging. And because the two grids are connected, in 7 minutes time, both of these drives will be fully charged. And that is a short tutorial on merge blocks, some basic use of them and how they work, and some of the pitfalls that surround them, including a bug which will be fixed by Keen Software at some point. Hopefully, this has been some help. You've enjoyed it. And stay safe. Take care. Have fun. Enjoy the game. Loads more to come. I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.